everyone. Welcome to my channel, Karla K Art. My name is Karla. This channel is all about my artwork, and I specialize in hand-painted silk. And if you like this channel, if you like this video, of course, press like. And if you want to subscribe and see more of my videos, please press the subscribe button below. I do art demonstrations on hand-painted silk. I talk a little bit about the methods and the processes involved in hand-painted silk. And of course, you get to see all of the work that I'm currently doing. So today I'm working on applying resist to a piece of silk that's stretched and on the stretcher frame. It already has a light pencil drawing on it, and the pencil drawing will come out in the final wash, so that's not something you're going to see those lines. I'm going to be applying a resist to the design, and a resist kind of works like a fence to contain the dye or to stop the dye from spreading. And so I have a couple colors of resist that I'm going to use today, a black and a clear resist. Here we go. So this is the black resist that I have. I buy it a bit in bulk because I do a lot of artwork. And so I've put it, a small amount of it into this applicator bottle, and it's just a squeeze tube. And I'm going to go ahead and apply the dye. One thing I should point out is that the tip of this this squeeze tube is actually a mechanical pencil head, and I use a fairly large size SARS diameter, a fairly large size pencil head when I'm doing my work. The finer heads tend to get jammed a lot easier, and if you push really hard on this container, you can actually pop this thing off, and I don't want that to happen. So I use pressure as a way of making thin lines and thick lines. The more pressure I put, the thicker the line will get. So I just wanted to point that out as a helpful little tip to you if you're out there hand painting silk on your own and you're having a problem with this tip jamming all the time. Try a larger tip nub, and you can buy the tip nubs from supply stores, or you can just braid one off of one of your mechanical pencils. Okay, I'm gonna go ahead and start. And oh, I believe this is a seven, a size seven. I'm gonna go ahead and start. Now, some of the lines I have in the center here are actually, I'm going to use clear on them, so I'm not going to shade those in right now. I'm going to do those in a little bit. Now, I'm going to do his eyes next, and I want to do his eyes in my world. I want to either do his eyes right side up or both upside down, but not sideways or anything, because I want to make sure that they're level. I want to make sure they're the same size. Oops, I didn't get it on my chin. I want to get them the same size. And I want them to have the same type of expression. So now I'm going to go over and do some white areas inside this drawing. Now I have the basic drawing done, so now I've got to wait for this to dry. That takes about 10 or 15 minutes, and then I will come back and I will paint it. Hi, I'm back. And the resist is all dried now, and so I'm going to go ahead and start applying the dye. Now I'm using special silk dyes to dye the fabric. They're especially made to become color fast in the silk once they've been set. And these particular dyes I set with a steaming method, so that you know how that all works. And I do have another video about how I steam my fabric, and I have videos of what my steamer looks like, and do check that out if that is something that interests you. So the dyes I have, you can't see in this particular picture, here they are here, my palette is underneath my frame. But I'm going to go ahead and start painting this in. Now, I start with a pretty primary palette and then mix a bunch of different colors together to get all the colors in my palette. Primary colors being red, blue, and yellow, if you're not familiar. And painting on silk is kind of like watercolor in that white is literally the silk itself. So if I want to paint something white, I have to not put any paint on it, any dye on it. Now, in addition to having the palette with all the colors in it, I usually have a plastic palette to help me carry my paintbrush so it doesn't drip onto the fabric. Sometimes you might see me do it with a little towel, but I do it with a plastic palette often. And colors of the lion. He's very yellow and a little bit of this brown. And I can also use this tray to mix stuff. So there we go. And he has some white in him. I can always go darker. I cannot make it lighter, really. This is tea. Okay. So. So this is black, and I'm going to fill in some of these spaces with black. Now I find it interesting, and I said this when I was drawing it, and all of the cat shapes that I draw, they actually have a bowl, like a bowl that you would rope, or that a male cow. They actually have a bowl shape in the middle of their nose. I'm not sure why that is, but I do. Now I'm going to be pretty bold on the application of color here. And I am letting the silk dry in places over here, which is not something that you often do when you're hand painting silk because it creates a line. But in this particular case, I think it's going to make the mane look more realistic, so I'm going to let it happen. And I think the use of black around this edge is really going to make his head pop out. Too worried about drips happening in here, just like the lines forming from when the silk dries. I think that it might create for some interesting shapes in the mane that might actually look more like mane. Trying to make some green here. this is white, but I want it to have some color in it because I'm sure in the reality of it, it's never really ever white because of when they eat and stuff, they get stuff on it. But the lines that I drew with the clear resist will also help lighten it up. And when the silk, see, here's an example of what happens when the line forms, but I think from the silk drying before it's finished its shape, because there was no line there to stop it, it made that line, but I think that that's going to look good with the line's mane. Now, there's some shading that occurs because the lion's mane has like layers to it. If you look at it closely, you look at a picture of it closely, and so it kind of goes light to dark, you know, light to dark. So I'm adding some dark areas to show where areas are above and below others in their mane. And I'm just making this up as I go along. I'm doing this from memory. The original drawing, I looked at some different pictures that I had of lions, including some that I'd taken myself of the lions at the local zoo. I'm going to do another layer of red, but this time I'm going to use a more earthy red. This is not so magenta-y. And I'll combine it with a little bit of yellow. And I'm jumping around a bit because I want it to be kind of balanced out. So it's that it turns orange. I'm going to start adding some brown here in a second. Brown really tones down the pink. The brown that I have is a bit grainy. It's a little bit of an older dye. I don't use as much brown in my work, so it's lasted a bit longer. And this particular type of brown I'm using, they've discontinued the brand. So there's no point in trying to complain or anything like that. I'm just using it as it is. And actually, when I use it in situations like this, and like if I use it for a tree trunk, some of the graininess in it actually creates its own design and is quite attractive. So I've learned to take advantage of what might be otherwise considered an imperfection. And this brown is really heavy on the red. So sometimes I add a lot of yellow to it to kind of bring it up. I'm going to go ahead and do his inner eyes. So that part filled in with the resist, but this part didn't fill in, so I'll fill that in. Now he looks a lot more balanced already. Now the inner color of the lion's eyes that I've seen are brown or they're golden. So I've got this golden yellow that I'm going to use. I'm just going to do that for now. And then I might go in afterwards and do some more shading on the other side. And the outside edge here, I'm gonna use a smaller paintbrush. The outside edge here is all black. It almost
almost looks like he's like Cleopatra. He's wearing some eyeliner. And then I'm just going to try and lighten up this.
Now I could get out a bigger paintbrush, but I like using the smaller paintbrush because it allows me to add more detail. It doesn't get so much dye on it, so the dye doesn't spread as far, and I can get more colors mixed in. But if soap painting is something you are deciding that you want to do, you're of course making your own decisions there. Whenever I used a bigger paintbrush, it has not worked out for me. So yes, I have tried it. This is going to be a really powerful subject when it's all done. All that red. I'm going to use some full strength brown in here. I don't know if I should try it somewhere. I think I should. Black and brown and get it up. Signature chips. Be a little bit careful there. I need some more red on the side. I need some red here. Okay, I'm going to turn this sideways so I can get out the side of it a little bit better. Dyes will do a great job of dyeing your hands, your skin. So if you're using the acid silk dyes, do use caution. I don't like to wear gloves because my hands sweat inside of them, and I usually end up getting more dye on me. A little false sense of security when I wear the gloves. So I'm going to go down here, a little bit of this purple, so it's like balanced, like I keep saying. And I'm working fast because I want to get to different areas of the silk and blend it out before it dries. So I might actually like to work a bit slower, but I don't always have that opportunity. And you can see I'm dripping quite a bit of extra dye on there. Okay, I'm going to shift the silk again. Woo. You can't see as I got coffee over here and I almost spilled my coffee. Hey, the coffee.
I'm from Seattle, and like most Seattleites, I value my coffee.
I'm going to take a moment here and just clean up my workspace for a second.
Bear with me, so I can keep myself fairly clean.
And my water is getting, if you can see it down here, it's getting pretty dirty. If I were going to go back and need to use a lot of really bright yellow, I would have to go clean out my water, but I'm doing primarily just the darkness on the outside here, so I'm not worried about the water making my piece look bad. If anything, the water might help my piece look better because it has some color in it and it has some depth in it. You can see this is actually, my water dish is actually kind of a light brown there. It's kind of a neutral gray. Neutral gray is what happens when you mix your three primary colors together and add white. When you mix the three colors together, generally speaking, you get brown. And then when you add white, it turns gray. I'll tip that for you there. My yellow is getting kind of low, and that's perfect for work like this because I want, when I go to clean out my yellow, I won't waste any yellow. I'll use it all up on this. I'm going to leave this light down here. I'm just adding some of this watercolor to it because I want there to be some bright spots in the piece so there's some contrast. And so here you have it. I just finished it. I just love painting on fabric because the movement really of the material actually really just, oh, it just brings the piece to life in a way that no other medium can. And now I have to wait for it to dry and to cure before I can steam set it and then wash it, iron it, market it for sale. And you'll find this piece on my Etsy store soon. I also wanted to let you know that if you like this video, if you press the thumbs up button, that would be great. And if you want to get more videos like this from me, you can press the subscribe button below and you can get notifications on when I put out new videos. If you press the arrow down below, it will open up an area where I have more information about links to my Etsy site where I sell my originals, links to my Fine Art America site where they sell prints of my work, and you can get pieces on images of my work on face masks, on yoga mats, on journals. You can even buy prints that you can hang in your house, as well as canvas paintings. They'll do a print on a canvas for you. So if that's something, if you're really interested in this lion piece and you want to have that in your house, you can do that through Fine Art America, and there's links down below. There's also a link to my website where I have a gallery. Thanks for joining me today for this demonstration on hand painting silk on this lion, and I hope to see you soon. Have a great day.